Okay, it looks like we have a full field to join the server again. So now we need to move on to race session. And it will of course be a rolling start once again. I'm not quite sure how far the safety car will drive before it pulls over. I'm not sure if it will do a full lap or only part of the lap before it releases the field. Okay, we see the cars join the field again, and we're about ready to get racing. There are 50 seconds until everybody has to join the field, the track, sorry. Okay, we're about to go racing once again. Now, of course, everybody has to move up to the starting order, which probably will be told to each car individually by race control, so they know where they start, since a restart can be somewhat confusing. Not quite sure where you are to place your car. place, so we have Team Kitty in the first place, and Energy Set in the B2. We have a 10-man project starting three, at first in the GG category, of course. Not sure Steve Steinecker is starting there, but we'll see when the race is released. Black Arrow SimSports starting second to last. At the back of them, there are the German in. Coming out to the back straight. Seconds, the safety car will pull over and the race will be released. Okay, we are green and we are racing. We have Team Kitty jumping in front. They had a bit of a jump start. FTZ wasn't paying attention at the start, but they already have a lead of a second. Team Meteon has moved up to B3. I don't know if that's the real that's the real place it's supposed to be. I don't know if the timing has been updated yet. I don't tell. And we have Black Arrow, SimSport, who they have already moved through the fields of PTs. They should be a lap down every other LMP. He's attacking Team Meteon quite hard. Whoa. Close driving. Here we have a P1 GC category 10-man project, followed by a Ford or the GC car. They are pulling a bit away from the rest, going down the back straight. Okay, like have the session updated with the correct placings on the simutils.dk timing session. So it's Team Kitty DK in place 1, Set in place 2, Team Meteon in place 3. We have the first DK card, 10-man project, Set, followed by Steen Steinecker, Formula Yamaha, Team Colding Racing 3, in place 5, it's Team Bernie Racing. In place 9, we have the Black Arrow LMP. They are moving field quite rapidly, and they are, it looks like, 2 laps down the other team cars. Okay, looks like Black Arrow is taking another lap at empty set. They have some It looks like Black Arrow Sim Racing has, I don't know, disappeared from the server again, perhaps, I'm not sure. Looks like disconnected again. That would mean that they are not going to... We are not going to have another server restart, as I remember the rules. You are only allowed one server restart per team, one disconnect per team. Okay, so Team Kitty is extending the lead quite a bit. They are 6 or 7 seconds ahead of FTZ now already, and we only done 2 laps. 1 lap. So there are no more cloak racing at the moment in the LMP class, but in the GT it's a lot more together. We have Steineken P5 followed closely by former Yamaha with either Peter Monkholm or Lasse Oko at the racing. And we have a close battle here as well, between Team Golden Racing and Team Bernie Racing. These are both 12 engines. They are fairly evenly matched, so it's going to be difficult to overtake pure speed. weather for this session after the server restart is much different from the previous. We have an ambient temperature of 26 and a track temperature of 33 degrees. So, we have a bit of a problem for Yamaha. They went off track about 3 joints. They didn't lose any places, but now they are pressured from behind by Team Folding, Burning Racing. How bumpy the track is in that corner, as Lassus spoke of earlier. It's very bumpy, the middle part of that corner, quite difficult. Makes the car jump to the outside of the track. It's hard to keep hard not to get understeer going through that corner. Always quite hectic after server restart. First stint until the pit stops begin, then you're racing quite hard. You're always very close since these GT cars aren't separated by much in regards to performance. So it's always the first stint is always quite hard racing, but it's fun also. Like Team Ezion has been overtaken by a 10-man project, so they must have had a problem from going off the track or whatever. And the FTZ guys, they have 19 seconds up to Team Kitty, so they're racing their own race at the moment. Quite a big difference between the two cars since they're identical. But they must have had different strategies when they set up the car.
Hello, Jan.
Hello.
What do you think about racing so far?
Well, the racing is tight, but it's been, with all the server restarts, it hasn't fallen into rhythm yet. But it's interesting to watch. But I still haven't figured out the different strategies that the teams have. I don't know, I haven't figured out how long they can go on one stint, since we haven't had a full stint yet.
Well, first of all, I'd like to tell the listeners that I am Peter Montlon. I was driving the Formula Yamaha, the FY car, for the first hour. So I only know a little bit something about the strategies from the 10-man project, because that was the car I was driving behind.
Yeah, but I think that the 4GT uses a bit more fuel than your system. Wouldn't you agree with that?
Yes, I think so. And I think they have about, you know, the car always in a stint comes into a certain period when it runs faster. I think they have the optimal car around 5 to 10 laps into their stint, and then it descends. Whereas in the Lister, we actually have the best laps on second, third lap, and then it just slowly goes down from there.
Okay. Oh, we had a Sting Steinecke went off the track, I could see, and you formerly a Yamaha moved into fifth place now. And he got overtaken by Golding also.
He created quite a lump of traffic right there.
Yep. It's always a dangerous time when a car leaves the track and rejoins, and you have fast cars coming up from behind. Always create some exciting moments.
Yes, and he's going to be out of rhythm when he's been off track, so he's not up to his usual pace.
He has a bit of dirt on his tires also.
Slowing down the Ferrari behind him right now.
Yeah. Oh, he gone wide again. Yeah.
That was an opportunity for the Ferrari, but he didn't take it.
Oh, if he's unsure what the other driver will do, perhaps you can stop thoughts of that.
Yeah, he may be just sitting behind waiting what's going to happen. It's a 12-hour race after all.
GT category, I can see that we have 10-man project and Formula Yamaha doing lap times around high 54s, low 55s. But these three that we have in the picture, they're doing 57s at the moment. So they are slowing each other down.
Well, I for one can't complain.
No, that would be stupid, wouldn't it?
Really would.
before the start of Peter, did you expect to be battling the Tin Man Project? Do you have any other cars as your main competitors?
We actually have a complaint, standing complaint about the start, because Simutil's timing registered a lap that was about half a second faster for the 10-man project than the lap they actually did, and we intend to prove that they didn't have the pole position, because they had a cut track warning on that particular lap.
Okay, but apart from that complaint, did you expect to be to the 10-man project to be the fastest car that you had to be battling back?
Yes and no. While I was driving behind, we were driving an economic setup and trying to save as much fuel as possible. And then right before our incident with the FTC car, we upped the pace, and we saw that we were actually from half to about a second faster than the 10-man project car. So their car definitely fades at the end of a stint, but they are faster in the beginning, and we just have to accept that.
But you have the economic on your side.
I hope so. We don't entirely know yet. Because of all the restarts, everyone's been starting with full tanks again.
We're looking at Emetion, and they have been able to retake their third position that they lost earlier, about 15 minutes ago. They haven't been able to overtake the 10-man project. That's a bit surprised to me that they aren't able to get more speed out of that LMP car.
I think Jeppe, the driver of Team Emetion, he's single driver, and he's just leaning back and just to try and complete the race will be a big success for him, I think.
I would have to agree with that. It's quite a task to do 12 hours alone.
Yes, I should think so.
But I also think that Lasse spoke of Sten Steineke. He hasn't reported any co-drivers. Or maybe he's doing it alone also.
Maybe.
Looks like Team Kitty is coming up to overtake some slower cars. Let's see which car it is. It's the Team Bernie Racing, I think. So he's already going to take a lap in the GT car. Let's hope he does a better job of it than just before the server restart. He took out two cars coming up on the safety car. Spaulding overtook Steinecker because he went a little white during the overtake of Team Kitty. And Spaulding has moved up to P3 in the GT category. But they're not able to open up a hole time. So they are fairly evenly matched these two cars.
Yes, and last time he was ahead of Stenik, he didn't manage to pull away. It seemed like Steen was able to just irritate him enough, or something, to just make him drive a little bit slower.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure who's driving. What's he calling it? I don't think it's been you, I'm not sure. Normally Ben Jewell is a bit slower, but he's also a bit more stable than others. Won't get irritated as much, make stupid mistakes.
Have a look at that. When he's ahead, Steen's able to catch on and hang on. And then when Jim Collins behind, he's obviously faster.
But they're certainly driving pretty... close to each other.
That was a good move by Steen. It's a very good overtake.
Yep. Okay, we're approaching the top of the second hour, and that should just run through the positions. First position, we have Team Kitty on lap 47. They are ahead of FTZ. They have 28 seconds down to FTZ, so that's quite a margin, quite a lead. P3, we have Team Ezion on a P car. They have retaken a P3 position moments ago. They are the 1.5 laps down and set up. Then in P4 we have the first place GT car, 10-man project for GT. They have completed 45 laps at the moment. And in P2 category, we have Formula Yamaha, driven currently by Lasse. They are, according to the timing, they are one lap down, but I'm not sure if that's correct. Then in P3, we have Sting Steinecker, who's also driving a 4GT. It is 8 seconds behind Formula Yamaha. Then we have a close battle, because right behind Sting Steinecker we have Team Colding 3, and we have Team Bernie Racing, but Team Bernie Racing, no, they made up a lap, according to the timing, so they are on the same lap as the cars in front of them. He... P6, sorry. We had the German entry of the German race team. I don't know what they're racing. But they are four laps behind. So they had a problem at the start of the race when they didn't join the server. So they had to wait for the first restart.
It's the drivers from the German Team German SH from the GTR 24H. I know that Frank and the guys are looking at this race as a preparation for this year's GTR 24H event.
Okay. They are only two drivers now, am I correct?
Yes, but I think they have some help from the rest of the team.
Okay. See from their lap times that they are 2 to 3 seconds slower than the rest of the GT cars. So we have to pick up the pace a little bit.
What do you think of that livery on the Kitty, Team Kitty DK car, Jan?
It's colorful. I don't have any other words for it.
Yeah, colorful. Yeah, that's it.
It's not very masculine. It's not a masculine car.
It's slightly to the soft side.
Especially if you look at that little cat front. That's, yeah, I don't know what to say.
We can let the viewers have their own opinions. But I definitely don't think you'll see a car like that in any endurance racing in real life.
Hopefully not. Like Team Bernie Racing has overtaken Sten Steineken. So now Sten is down to the fifth position in the GT category. And now Team Bernie has also overtaken Team Kolding. These guys keep making mistakes all the time, so they switch positions. That's what happens when you have close race. You tend to make a bit mistakes, small mistakes. You get stressed a little bit when you're in close combat or something.
Yeah, close combat was just what I was thinking of.
That's not bad, but racing.
Yeah, I was thinking of the dogfight, you know, aeroplanes constantly turning and diving and shooting at each other.
Yeah, that's what these guys are doing.
Just thinking that 10 teams is actually pretty good for a 12-hour race. And then I was thinking we could have had more cars in battles like this. But at the moment, I think for these guys, it's actually pretty good that there's not any more cars, because that would just have created a lot of more crashes, I think.
Yeah, I think you're right. But you also have to take into consideration that normally in the DGTL, we race alone. Now we have put a lot of drivers together, so that would of course hurt the number of cars on track. So I think it's quite good to have 10 cars on the track, or yeah, 9 cars since Black Arrow has disappeared.
Yeah, sorry for them. That's just I know they. They decided to race at Carsten's place today because they would have better internet connections there, and I think it's their internet connection that's playing up. Oh, it's a new attempt from Sting.
Let's see who breaks last.
It's a good thing about Sebring, the way you can use a lot of different lines into the turns. It'll give a lot of close racing.
Yeah, but the move that Steve made there kind of put a hole between him and Team Colding. So that was quite an impressive.
Yesterday I was actually talking with Chris from the drivers from the 10-man project, and I was discussing a move exactly like the one that Steen made there, and I was saying that if you took a later apex into that turn, you could actually on the exit of the turn go inside very fast.
Yeah, maybe Steen listened on that conversation.
He may have been, yeah.
Bernie Racing has got a little hold down to the other two cars now. Perhaps he will be able to extend the lead now that he has some quiet.
Then I'll have to start getting ready for my next step, so I'll leave you here again. Maybe Lasse will come and talk to you when he's out of the car.
That's okay. Good luck on your next stint.
Thanks.
Okay, so the lead car has done 21, 22 laps since the server restart. So perhaps we're going to see some regular pit stops coming up soon. I'm not sure how long those diesel LMPs will be able to go on a tank of diesel. But since they only carry about 80 liters, they should be close to pit. Class leaders have a comfortable lead now. Team Kitty has around 43 seconds down to their closest competitor. And Tin Man Project seems like they have a whole lap down to Formula Yamaha. So that's quite comfortable. But it's a long race. Still have almost 10 hours of racing to do. So a lot can happen. But it looks like Formula Yamaha is gaining a bit. Not a whole lot, but a little bit. So you could see the Tin Man Project now on the same straight. Bernie Racing has also been able to extend their lead down to Team Colling, so they have a bit of a cushion now. They're not direct in fight with other cars at the moment, so perhaps they'll be able to calm things down and go a bit easy on the tires. Colding also have a small cushion down to Steen Steinecke, so they can also, not take a deep breath and relax, but be able to drive more focused, drive the correct lines, all that. Team Colling has made a mistake and got overtaken by Steen Steinecke again, but perhaps the cushion wasn't enough. But it's great racing. It's fun to watch. It looks like Jimmy John has had an accident. Jimmy John is in the pits for repairs. Oh, and we have first ordinary pit stop. Looks like FTZ is going in. Oh, sorry, Team Kitty has had to have gone in before them.